for now. Thank you very much, sir. Ken Hagel, you have a huge experience in this conversion process, and we're happy to have you with us today.
Thanks. I'm not here because I'm working at the chef school in Copenhagen. I'm here because I spent 12 years in the Copenhagen House of Food. And those 12 years I will try to boil down in 5 minutes, which will not be a glaze, not a stock, but I will try anyway. It all had started in 2006, where we got a new Lord Mayor, who set the target for 90% organic in the metropolitan of Copenhagen. And that's the process that we want to make that change. But she wanted to do it, and she wanted to raise the quality as well. So it's not just to turn it into become organic, but also to raise the quality of the public food. So that's what we did. It's 70,000-90,000 meals a day. It's 900 kitchens, give and take. When such a big city, you cannot give just a specific number, but roughly 900 kitchens is 1,700 workers, 5,000 to 6,000 working with the meals, because that's a really important part of the world. The story tells of what the food was. It's 10% of the public procurement in Denmark. That's Copenhagen, and that's what we want to change to become 90% organic. Did we achieve? In 2009, we had 60%. And when you get 60%, it starts to change. You have to change the way of cooking, you have to change the way you work in the kitchen. At 75, you get a little more change. When you get above 65%, suddenly you have to change the meat as well, and that's expensive. I have to say that the change to 60 or 75% had to become within the same budget. So the kitchen didn't get any more money. And I think that's really important for the success. Of course, some of them was giving too little money, they were serving too little food. Or if the people were eating the food, they had to serve more. Because that was the fact that it wasn't eaten because it was so terrible. And in 2050, did we achieve 90%? No, we did not. We only achieved 88%. So we never got the 90% in all the kitchen, but we got the 88, which was close enough. We used the marks. As you see, they came in, so we didn't have a 75% mark. But we use them now, and they're used in Copenhagen today, 90% organic. And it's really great to have a system where when you work with the kitchens, and you're not controlling them. So that's why we call it a hygiene factor. The organic was done, controlled by the state, not by me. So I didn't care if you're cheating or not. I just want to work with the kitchen. And that's really a great system. I think there should be a 75, but anyway, it's really a great system, and we'll work a lot with it. We did it with something called a rating tool, a development tool, where we went into the kitchen and tried to motivate them to change the way of cooking. And to make this really briefly, so we can have a debate afterwards, I want to show you what's happened in the kitchen before we got in. And this is an elderly home where elderly people are living. Some of them have dementia. And when we came in first, it's 100% processed food, cooked from scratch. It's all cooked by the industry. It's 60% of the staff who are serving the food refused to eat it themselves when we asked them. No host or no food focus on the meal at all. They just left the food. Nobody was giving a care of serving it the right way. 60% of the people living at the elderly home was malnourished. And the job satisfaction in the kitchen, well, they have 10% sick days. So that was before we got in, and the leader of the elderly home got furious when I said, I don't know if the kitchen can cook, they are skilled, so they probably can, but they haven't cooked this meal, it's cooked by the industry. They didn't understand it. What happened when we finished? This one became 90% organic. 100% was cooked from scratch. The last time I went to this elderly home, they came to me and said, oh, Kenneth, you have to look. And I got into the kitchen, I was, what? They were doing everything, they were doing their own bacon, they were smoking their own salmon, everything was done from scratch. I said, we are starting to make the sausages. We are making salami now. And we didn't dare teaching them that. But they did it themselves. Everybody is eating the food, even the staff who's serving the food are eating at the meals. All the meals have a host telling the story of why there is not so much meat, telling them why it's important that it's organic, because you cannot taste it's organic, but why should I eat organic? In the beginning, the elderly says, well, I'm just gonna die anyway. Why should I eat organic? So it's really, you have to tell the story. This is a small elderly home. They have 37, 1 malnourished only because she's elderly. They only have 2% sick days. And 90% of the food is organic and it's made within the same budget. It's made with the same budget for staff. They're only 3, there were 5 before, but now they are 3. But they are skilled chefs, 2 of them, and 1 of them are nutritionist. And they cook everything themselves. And those 2 chefs are having a blast. The thing is so much fun, doing everything. Not even the restaurants are doing their own salami. So they have fun doing it. And the people who are eating that, you get real food. So I think this is the real importance of changing to organic. It's really changing the mindset of food, changing the food system, changing everything within the organic and have the organic movement to make this change.
Thank God for Rick Biago that she wanted to do this and she started this.
So when you do it and when you get above 30%, you have to make a change. I didn't know if you were German or English or whatever, so it's in German, sorry. Even I don't understand it.
What you do?
You have to do the change. You have to do the change in the mindset. You have to do the change in the pots to become 90% organic. If you don't do that, it's really expensive. Some of the really expensive canteens make the change by this, just by money. And it's 40% to make this change. More expensive. But if you want to make the change within the same budget, you have to change the way you think. You can change to 30%, but then you have to pay 20% more. Does it make any sense? Mm-hmm. So you have to change the way you cook, you have to cook real food, and that's the best thing about this. So thank you, Rick Biago, thank you, the Danish government, for making this change.
Thank you very much.
Just in line with the others, the most important thing is involvement of the different partners, the commitment, and that they take ownership on it. They can see an idea with it, because obviously, I mean, all the parties, they do it also because, I mean, they can see a business case in it. It has to make sense. So, yeah. But also, just one thing that I was hoping you would mention as well, like some of the, I've heard your story a lot of times, but all the derived effects that you cannot take one separate part and say that it's because of the organic conversion, but you can just see that it happens when you convert into organic.
Thank you very much, Sarah. And then Kenneth, please remember the last 2 questions.
Yes, yes, there was done a campaign in Copenhagen. We used a lot, some of the money to go to a professional campaign company and did a huge campaign where we took a picture of all the kitchen workers in Copenhagen and posted them as the local heroes, because we want to show them that they were the local heroes. So we did some campaigning to get them motivated and really work for it. Yes, people hate it when you say that they are not cooking good food, but I didn't say they didn't cook good food, I said they didn't cook it. That was difficult to communicate even in Danish. And yes, we have to motivate the kitchen workers, and we have to give them education. And as if we are here at Biofag, I think the numbers of kitchen workers at this place is close to 0. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of people working around it that's here. Mm-hmm. Kitchen workers? No. They are standing in the kitchen, they are going in from the bank, they are going home with a poor salary. We have to put them up front and treat them as local heroes. take them, what we do normally is put them on a bus and drive to a farm to get the farmer to tell their story about why it should be organic. Oh, and say, oh, that makes sense. So get that connection. And what we have to really realize is that we are changing the system. So we cannot just do as usual. We are cooking in a new way, we are buying in a new way. And yes, the control should be really easy. There shouldn't be any friction with the controlling, because the kitchen worker has plenty to do doing the cooking.
Thank you very much, Kenneth. Let's give it again. With the panel and our good colleagues from the Danish Veterinary and Food Administration just outside the room. I will also